If you're not here with me, what is love?
Start to blush when somebody says your name. In my stomach, there's a place when you walk in my direction. I go the other way. I start to shudder when I speak.
Start to stand, my knees go weak.
What it do, it's not you, but it's me. It's your girl, Lil Denise. And I'm back with another bang. Welcome to the channel. Go ahead and like this video right now. Comment videos you guys want to see me do. And on the count of three, subscribe. 1, 2, 3. Wow, hit the subscribe button. Thank you for subscribing. Welcome to the channel. Thank you for joining the Heart Family. It's lit. Roll to 5K subs. Let's run these subs up, man. Once we get to 5K subs, I do a giveaway. You feel me? And today, I have a very interesting lit video, you feel me? This literally just happened. That's why I got taped in the background. All of your flaws! You feel me? Got the tink playing, you feel me? It's kind of a little Debbie Downer, you feel me? This video, you can see by that title and that thumbnail. I got rejected. About my crush, you feel me? It's gonna be a story time about how I, you know, got rejected in the process, you feel me? So, without further ado, let's get into the video. If I'm not gonna give like specific details about where I met her at and, you know, the reason why I started, I'm gonna tell you the reason why I started liking it. So I did meet her this year. In June, I want to say I did meet her in June. The first time I saw her, I was like, whoa. She didn't.
Damn, she fine.
She didn't even have to say nothing. The first time I saw her, it was like. But, you know, I didn't know, you know, at the time, that whether she was straight or gay, you feel me? So I kind of kept it to myself and it kind of kept going on. And I saw her again, you feel me? And I wouldn't say the feelings grew stronger, but I would say I was more attracted to her, only based off of stuff that she would do, and she wasn't. So yeah, after the first time, like I said, I was like, whoa, oh my goodness. So I was like, I'm gonna just sweep that shit under the rug, you feel me? I wouldn't say I was fresh out of a relationship, but I was kind of vulnerable at the time, so I was like, I ain't really feeling her like that for real. I'm just needing somebody. But, you know, as time went on, I was completely over my previous relationship, and I saw her again. She took a mask off. I remember the first time I see her, she had on boots, jeans, and like a one of those big rolls thing that girls wear. Like, it was like sweater-like. You know those, I think it's like a throw, they call it a throw. It's like a big sweater thing, but it's long. It was cute. And the next time I saw her, she just had, what really got me, cause like I said, the second time I saw her, I seen her, she was just sitting there, and she was like, I'm gonna take my mask off, cause you're gonna be seeing more of me. And everything was just chills from my stomach down to my vagina, made that motherfucker jump, feel me? And then after that, but what I really like about her, I like her, her hair. She has some really nice hair, and she had a mohawk, I want to say. And she had a mohawk. Yeah, she had a mohawk. I'm lying, like, I don't know. I know, because I'm really observative, and I pay attention. She was natural. She has mohawk, and she had a mohawk, and she was, it was nice. And the thing also I liked about her, she didn't make stuff too obvious. She didn't, not saying that she was giving me hints or nothing like that. It's like, she just, she was real honest, you know, about a lot of shit. Not that we talk on that type of shit. It's like, again, you could just get on just a vibe from somebody like this person is really genuine, you know. And that's what I got from her. She was just genuine. She was cool, and I wanted to get to know her. Based only off of energy, you know. We, like I said, we really didn't even talk. Just her energy and her hair. She has nice hair, and her eyes are nice. And she dressed nice. She carries herself really, really nicely. She's dressed really presentable. She doesn't like, she doesn't have to show a lot. She dressed really nice. She doesn't try too hard. She was just naturally gorgeous, beautiful individual. And I didn't know how or what to say, because, you know, some girls get offended when you you act, let's go out, or you feel more, you're interested in girls. So I didn't want to offend her, because I didn't want to potentially mess up a nice friendship. Because, like I said, you can really get a vibe from somebody if they're, you know, they're genuine. And that's what I got from her. That's why I really wanted to get to know her better on that tip as well, as a friend. And touch each other's fun parts, possibly. But, you know, so it actually took me from June up until tonight, when I'm filming this video, October 5th. Today's October the 5th. It took me from June up until now to say something. It was eating me up. Every day I thought about this girl. Every day. I can just have just one thought of her, and then just everything just happens. Like, I just get really, really extremely turned on and smile when I talk about her. Just cheeks is up high, blushing. It was just like, that shit was crazy. Like, it was just eating me up, you know what I'm saying? Then, like I said, I didn't want to say anything because I didn't know her sexual status, or well, she's gay, straight, or whatever. But so I was asking people, you know, how should I approach it? Should I say something? Should I not? I knew eventually that I was gonna have to say something, because it was killing me not to. You feel me? Because I had to know. You feel me? And so I was, like I said, weeks, and I've been, and then, before I even said something, I was lurking. Accidentally called her a few times. Lurking, just trying to look at her. I was honestly just trying to look at her. Like, why would I call you? Like, because we ain't even on that tip. But I wanted to be, so by my dumb self, trying to scroll and be lurky, called her. And I apologize for me. So I should have known then when she didn't respond, be like, oh, it's okay. But like I said, I was fucking with her heavy. Like, I like her, you know? She just seemed like a really, really genuine, honest person, you feel me? Like someone that you could just really be really cool with. And she wasn't bad, she looked nice as well, you know? And then most of the time when I saw her, she was sitting down. And I seen a picture of her standing up. Like, this motherfucker got a house for a back, for her ass. Like, she was thick. Under my a baby. Like, I'm like, damn, so this made it worse. Like, this made it worse. That's what you get for lurking. This made it worse. So when I saw that, it just went up. It went up, you feel me? I had to say something. So I did, because I was like, hey, I'm interested. I've been wanting to talk to you for a while. Are you interested in girls? If not, you know, it's cool. And she said, I'm not. She said, I'm not. I mean, I think it was best if I go ahead and know now, because, like I said, she was all I can think about. I would wake up thinking about her, go to sleep thinking about her. It was like, I think it was more because I really just wanted to be her friend, but she wasn't a bad looker as well. Like I said, I love girls with natural hair. It's like my weakness, like natural pretty hair, her eyes, she smelled nice. She's just a nice person in general. Like I said, she kept it honest with me. She just was really nice about certain situations that she could have been really nasty about. So I fucked with it. And that first day I saw her, when she walked in that room, I'm like, damn. It was the mohawk. I like her with a natural hair. But once I shoot, they were talking about, shoot your shot, Lil. You only live.
YOLO!
it. She can either say yes or no. I'm like, fuck it. I was saying fuck it for months, but tonight, it was just eating me up too bad, because I saw her again. So I had to say something. So I sent her a message. She didn't really be too, I don't think she was offended. She just said, I'm not, you know? And she was really cool about it. So that's what I'm saying. It was really fucking awesome of her. She said, I'm not interested in girls. And that's completely fine. You know, not all girls are interested in girls. You feel me? That sucks for them girls that are not. Because girls are lit. We're fun. But, yeah. That was the story time about how my crush turned me down. I was crushing heavy. Like, really heavy. But, yeah, that was the end of that video, man. She said she was not interested in girls. She was a nasty body. She took it really well. You know, so... So, you know what I'm saying? Got them babies, you feel me? Then I was like icing other girls because I really wanted this girl. I could be with these other girls, even about to like be on dates with other girls and think about that girl. I could even be having sex with a girl and I was thinking about her. And she didn't give me no indication, nothing, that she was gay. Just her energy, her vibes, her the way she carries herself, her smell, her eyes, her hair. She just looked like she would be really awesome. So yeah, if you like that story time, you guys want to see other videos. I was heartbroken when she said that, but moving on. So if you guys want to see other videos, you know what I'm saying, other story times, go ahead and like this video right now and comment videos you guys want to see me do. We're finna be the latest YouTube channel right now, you feel me? So if you like consistent, honest, transparent videos, this is the channel for you. You know what I'm saying? So go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Hit that subscribe button. And I'll see you, and in the next video. Why? Because I can and I will.